is, if you don't know it, Rhapsody in Blue by George Gershwin. That's the clarinet solo that opens that piece. It's maybe the very first thing that you heard on the clarinet if you grew up watching Fantasia, Walt Disney's Fantasia. So I am here to tell you how to do this on clarinet. It's actually pretty easy to get started doing it, but it, like most things on the clarinet, it takes some practice and getting used to and a little bit of nuance. I'm also going to show you why it is impossible to do on the bass clarinet. Some of you may already know the reason, but those of you who don't, I'll show you why. So, how do you make that glissando sound on the clarinet? Well, first of all, let's call it what it is technically called, which is a smear. So how do you make this smearing sound? Well, how do you make any sound on a clarinet? Well, let's take a look. Normally, when you lift up a finger, all of us should know this by now, when you lift up your finger, you get a higher note. When you lower your finger, you get a lower note. But what happens if you pull your finger off this way, slowly? Let's give that a listen. That's the secret right there. And it takes a lot of practice because you have to put more air into the instrument when you're making that sound, because the instrument, when you pull your finger off, all of a sudden becomes a lot more resistant. What is resistant? Again, resistance is when the instrument feels like it, you have to blow harder to make your sound. Because the instrument is not operating efficiently like it's supposed to, because you're slightly, basically you're creating a leak in the clarinet. When you pull your finger off that way, the instrument responds by being harder to play. So you have to have a lot of air support and you have to push. Okay, so that's the first step. You pull your finger off. Now the second thing is, you don't just pull this finger off and then pull this finger off and then pull this finger off. You kind of do them all at once. Here, let me show you. Now, when you pull your fingers off, you sort of pull, and once this finger is started, you kind of just let the rest of them pull off. And then when these are just about kind of halfway off, you start pulling these fingers up, et cetera, et cetera. That's the whole secret. You just smear your fingers off. Now there's one little problem, and that is that not every key that lifts up gets pulled off by your fingers. Some of them, the instrument itself pulls up. Let me show you what I mean. When I play a G and I push just this pad down, not the F, but I push this pad down, you get kind of a G half flat. Well, how do you get from to without hearing that discrete? Well, here is the secret. You'll notice that when I push any one of these keys down, doesn't matter which one I push down, this pad gets pushed down because they're all attached by this rod. This rod, if once you've pulled these fingers off, you still have this finger touching it. I let this finger kind of become the fulcrum and it lets this slowly open like that. And that's a practice thing. The same thing goes for this note, and the same thing goes for this note, because both of these two notes have not just the ring and the open hole, but a key attached to it, and that takes practice. Finally, I want to show you something else. How the heck did I do that? I'm not moving any of my fingers. Nothing up my sleeve. How that is all done is in your throat. Now, we've talked a million times about voicing. Here's one of the times you get to use voicing in practice. So what you do is you kind of play that high C and then you drop your jaw and your tongue and you go E-I. Watch this part of my throat and my jaw. All of that is done with my throat. So if you lower your tongue like that, do the smear, and when you get up to that high C, let your tongue finish pulling that note up into tune, then you just go on with the rest of the solo. That's how you make this thing work. So I bet a lot of you are wondering, hey, can I do this on the bass clarinet? And the answer is no, you can't do this on the bass clarinet. Well, why, might you ask, can't I do this on the bass clarinet? And it has to do with how the bass clarinet keys work. First of all, if you own a bass clarinet, you will notice that none of the keys are open, like on a clarinet. Your fingers aren't touching the wood of the bass clarinet like they are on the clarinet. Each one of these keys has a pad attached to it. The reason is that the holes are too big, your fingers would fall into it, so the bass clarinet needs those pads because those pads are bigger than your fingers. So if I were to try and do this, sound the same, does it? And it doesn't sound the same because I cannot pull my fingers off like I am on the clarinet. Now, you might also ask, well, you said that you could do that thing where you pivot your fingers and you slowly open those pads. Well, that would be great, except you have to do that with all of those pads at slightly different times. It becomes almost impossible. Believe me, I've tried. Here, I'll give it my best shot one more time. Can't do it. That is Gershwin's Rhapsody in Blue for clarinet and not bass clarinet. If you have any questions, you know where to put them. I hope this was helpful. We will see you next time. Good night.